Thank you, Moulika. A physician is obligated to consider more than a diseased organ, more than even the whole body. He must view the man in his world. Respected judges and the fellow delegates, a very warm morning to one and all. Today, I, Moulika, and my friend Osmania are here to present the story of the case of an 18-year-old boy born with a lump on the back and eventually developing end-stage renal disease. Coming to the case, the patient was born with a lump on the back at birth, which was diagnosed as Myelomeningocele. He had no developmental abnormalities or delay in the milestones, but at 15 years of his age, he developed urinary incontinence, suggestive of urogenic bladder. Till 18 years of his age, he was not treated for any of that. But at 18 years of his age, he underwent surgery for the removal of myelomeningocele. After the surgery, the problems of his urinary bladder did not subside. He was on condom catheters later. After seven months of his surgery, he developed fever with chills, and his renal function test showed azotemia. And also, he was provisionally diagnosed with urinary tract infections causing acute kidney injury on chronic kidney disease stage 5, and he underwent his first hemodialysis. Then he was kept on a Foley's catheter later. After 3 months of his first dialysis, he came to our OPD with bilateral fetal edema and decreased urinary output since 10 days. He mainly came to our hospital in view of maintenance hemodialysis. He was later admitted to the ward. During hospitalization, he had focal seizures with secondary generalizations. He had an episode of severe headache and vision loss for a day. He was also complaining of weakness in all four limbs since 7 months. Past history, he is not a known case of primary hypertension, diabetes mellitus, bronchial asthma, or tuberculosis. Family history, not significant. Drug history, no significant drug history. On examination, his vitals were all normal. He had failure on general examination, and auscultation of the lungs and heart revealed bilateral basal fine crepitations and heaving murmur heard in the pulmonary area. On CNS examination, his motor system, the power was found to be 3, the grade 3 on 5, across all four limbs. Donor's flaccid in all four limbs. Reflexes, there was hyperreflexia in all four limbs. Sensory system was intact in the pulmonary cerebellar findings. So this is the video of his placidity. The investigations. HP was 5.6 gram per deciliter. Renal function test, urea was 175 mg per dl, creatinine 7.4 mg per dl, uric acid 38.6 mg per dl, phosphorus was 6.5 mg per dl, potassium 3.3 mg per liter. Liver function test, albumin 2.56 gm per dl, total proteins 4.7 gm per dl. And urine culture report showed E. coli more than 10 power 5 coliforming units, and complete urine examination was normal. USG, bilateral hydroureteronephrosis and bilateral shrunken kidneys were shown. CT abdomen, there was emphysema and cystitis. So this is the sensitivity report of E. coli. He was sensitive only to phosphomycin and meropenem, which ended up with the treatment later. Now MRI brain. This is the decorated image of his brain, and as you can see, there is diffusely scattered white matter in the posterior region. Specifically, this is the AKI, this is a DWI, ADC DWI, and this is a flare image. Coming to the spine, here you can see there is at C3, C4, C4, C5, and C5, C6. There is disc loss and disc degeneration and the disc is lost. And here at L4, L5, we can see a fibrous tissue indicating myelomeningocele's surgical importance, and there is renal loss, dystrophy, and tumor. Diagnosis: myelomeningocele causing urogenic bladder and UTI with the E. coli report, and leading to AKI on CKD 5D on hemodialysis, bilateral hydroureteronephrosis, emphysema, and cystitis. Cervical spondylosis at C3, C4, and press. So now this is a new diagnosis on hospitalization. As we had, he had a vision loss, he had seizures, and headache. This short press, this and the MRI findings confirm the presence of press, like posterior retractable encephalopathy syndrome. This was the treatment, symptomatic and prophylactic. October is the awareness month for spina bifida. So let's see this. So we can see, since it's always better, I mean, prevention is better than cure, we can advise pregnant women to take folate, especially in the first trimester of their pregnancy. And then, so this guy from 15 to 18 years at his adolescent age, he was not diagnosed or he was not basically treated. So we can tell everybody about the importance of folate and also the importance of early surgery in these cases, because early surgery have proven to be more useful in order to reduce the complications in the myelomeningocele spina bifida patients. And thank you everybody.
And how do you explain the weakness in the upper legs?
Weakness actually to cervical spondylosis.
What is the age of the patient?
18 years old.
18 years old, age cervical spondylosis.
So that expired last Thursday due to retracting convoluting. So that's one of the.
Okay, he has the complications of renal failure.
Yes.
But cervical spondylosis will not come by 18 years. And the cord is not compressible. Either this or even osteopoints. There are no osteopoints that are to see the MRI. So what do you mean by meningomyelocele?
It is a congenital defect of the basically
spinal bifida. Spinal bifida usually occurs in three legs. Spinal bifida affects the meningocele and myelomeningocele. And out of course, the myelomeningocele is most the dangerous one of
That's not okay. What is myelomeningocele? So, what do you mean by myelomeningocele?
The spinal cord, during the urinary defect, I mean urinary formation, the spinal cord comes up, the meninges and this is all the common sac outside the spinal cord.
What is myelomeningocele? What is meningocele? What is myelomeningocele?
Okay, the nerve roots, when the nerve roots are involved, it is called myelomeningocele, and only there is a sac with only the CSF, then it's meningocele.
So, herniation of meninges. So, the defect is spinal. That is meningocele. If the neural contents also of herniated bladder, it is myelomeningocele. Why he developed urinary bladder? What is the cause for 175 in William, 7 creatinine?
Yes, ma'am. So, urinary bladder, since this problem is myelomeningocele, that is the lumbus at L4, L5 segments. Here we can see overflow in front. Here we can see hyperactivity or hyperreflexia of retrosome muscle. So,
hyper.
So, because of that, like there are two kinds of involvement seen or not, overflow and dripping of urine. So, because of hyperreflexia, there is overflow involvement, and dripping is due to the acidity of the gland.
When the gland is flaccid, it cannot be when the bladder tone is reduced, the bladder becomes flabby, so there is no urine output. So the pressure increases over the ureters. The ureters backfire, then the hydronephrosis, and then causes renal failure. Actually, in these conditions, you get flaccid bladder without sensations. So that's why the patient doesn't feel pain, can't pass urine. So this type of bladder only in a very seen more of it.
Because there is
thank you, Moulika and Abhimanyu. Going on to the next.